Hello students. Today we'll be talking about need and importance of educational guidance services in schools, and the areas we are going to touch are the concept of guidance and its major areas or types, educational guidance as one among the major areas of guidance, the nature and aims of educational guidance, and lastly we'll be talking about the importance of educational guidance services in schools. By now you have understood that guidance is a helping service. It is by its very nature a self-oriented, problem-solving and multifaceted activity. Guidance is a helping service. It is by its very nature a self-oriented, problem-solving and multifaceted activity. It presupposes twofold understanding. The first is the understanding of one's own abilities, aptitudes, interests, motives, behavior patterns, skills and achievements, up to date and social, cultural, economic background. Secondly, it is the understanding of the real nature of one's environment and of the educational and vocational opportunities offered by that environment, along with their differential requirements of abilities and attainments. Guidance may be described as a process of relating these two types of understanding so that they become imbued with a new meaning in the life of the individual. Mohin has very lucidly put the nature of guidance in these words. Guidance seeks to create within the child the need and power to explore and understand him or herself in order to prepare a balance sheet of his or her assets and liabilities so that he or she is able to plan out his or her future growth and activities in a manner that offers maximum likelihood of success and satisfaction. Types of guidance. Guidance is the help given by one person to another in making choices and adjustments and in solving problems. Guidance functions in all sort of problem situations, may be in educational, vocational or personal. Thus, there are different types of guidance programs depending upon the nature of a problem. It is an interesting phenomenon that educationists and guidance workers have been describing types of guidance in diversified ways. Many of them do not agree on the number and types of guidance. W. M. Prester described six types of guidance as educational guidance, vocational guidance, guidance as social and civic activities, guidance in health and physical activities, guidance in worthy use of leisure time, and guidance in character building. Patterson has grouped them into five types. One, educational guidance. Second, vocational guidance. Third, personal guidance. Fourth, health guidance. And fifth, economic guidance. If we examine the classification of all the psychologists, a common thread passes through mainly three types of guidance. These are educational guidance, vocational guidance and personal guidance. In the last two decades, guidance movement has spread like a wildfire throughout the world and generated a great amount of enthusiasm and zeal among parents, teachers and social workers who have devoted time to explore its feasibility and the utility for general population, including school-going adolescents. All are convinced that proper provision of guidance services should be made for children at different age levels for the harmonious development of their personalities in the larger interests of the society and the individual. Educational guidance. According to Arthur J. Jones, educational guidance is concerned with assistance given to pupils in their choices and adjustment with relation to schools, curriculum, courses and school life. It means that educational guidance is mainly concerned with such problems of education as are faced by students engaged in the study of different subjects for their vocational preparation. There are various issues which have been discussed by Brewer in his book Educational Guidance. One of the main concerns of educational guidance, as per Brewer, is to help the individual to make desirable progress in his or her educational career. Educational career is obviously the path of learning which has to be followed by a pupil. Dear students, now let us talk about guidance and education. The aims and objectives of guidance and education are so close to each other that people get confused at times. Wrinkle and Gilchrist has said, without good teaching, guidance is incomplete. Teaching and guidance are inseparable. Education in one sense means aiming at proper development of the child so that he or she becomes a good citizen and enjoys happiness in life, which is very true about guidance also. According to Proctor, guidance is a process of assistance given to an individual of making necessary adjustment to their environment and in distributing themselves to suitable vocation, recreational, health and social civic opportunities. In brief, the purpose of guidance seems to be self-realization and personality development. It also helps people to make necessary adjustment to this environment. It needs to be kept in mind that instruction is not guidance and must be carefully distinguished from it. At times, guidance does make use of instruction, but it is not self-instruction. We should be able to conceive that even when the aims and objectives of guidance are the same, which are that of education, the methods used by these two differs largely. That's why Jones once said that all assistance in learning is guidance, and at another place said that all guidance is education. But some aspects of education are not guidance. Their objectives are the same in the development of individual, but the methods used in education are by no means the same as used in guidance. Agreeing with Jones, Myers has said, adapting teaching methods to individual needs is not educational guidance. It is just good teaching. According to Crow and Crow, the aims and objectives of educational guidance at the high school level are, number one, select the curriculum that best fits abilities, interests, and future needs of the students. Develop work and study habits that enable them to achieve satisfactory success in their studies. Gain some experiences in learning areas outside the particular field of their special interests and talents. Understand the purpose and the function of the school in relation to their needs. Discover all that their school has to offer and plan a program of studies accordingly. Learn about the purpose and function of the school that they may wish to attend later. Select try-out courses in order to gain insight into learning areas that still lie ahead. Participate in out-of-class activities in which they can develop potential leadership qualities. Appraise their fitness for continued study in a college or other schools or in a particular vocation. Develop an attitude which will stimulate them to continue their education in a school selected for its worth to them in relation to their talents and training. Let's have a look over the need for educational guidance services. Dear students, there's a greater need for guidance services now than ever before due to the rapid advancement in technology, emerging of new world order, social change, globalization, liberalization, the need for outstanding leadership, a shift in standards of morality and integrity, people's high aspirations, etc., all contribute to the need for guidance services in school. We shall discuss the need for educational guidance in India under four heads, viz. Educational needs, vocational needs, personal needs, and social needs. Educational needs. Guidance is needed from educational point of view because of the following reasons. Individual differences among school-going children. We find much wider range of individual differences in the abilities, aspirations, and achievements of the people. Understanding of the differential needs and the abilities of the children is essential for modifying the school program for the best possible unfoldment of the students' potentialities. This is possible only through the introduction of guidance services in our school programs. Guidance as an instrument for the qualitative improvement of education. There has been a rapid expansion of educational facilities to cater to the needs of increasing number of children in recent years. This has resulted to some extent in the fall of educational standards. Consequently, there's a great need of providing guidance services in the school for the qualitative improvement of education. Diversified courses. At the second stage, the courses of studies have been diversified to include several optional groups. Therefore, a special type of service is badly needed in our schools, which will assist the individual people in the choice of courses suiting to their needs and abilities that will help the school authorities in the proper allocation of the diversified courses to the peoples of the school. Expanding educational objectives. It is now commonly accepted that education should also lead to the promotion of the emotional, social, and civic life of the student. Problems of the social adjustment and personality orientation require the service of a competent counselor and availability of appropriate guidance services. Educational issues. We are facing various types of educational problems in the schools, such as universal and compulsory education, increased enrollment, high percentage of failure and dropout, wastage and stagnation, etc. These problems require the need of proper guidance services in the school. Special guidance services are also required for the gifted, backward, handicapped and delinquent children. Maintaining discipline. Problem of discipline is becoming more and more acute in the educational institutions. Even at higher stage of education, it has taken a serious turn. Students' strike and agitation have become a common scene of the day. Understanding their issue is a great step to maintain discipline, which can be done with the help of guidance personnel. Optimum achievement of the students. The reason for the poor achievement in the schools is also because of students do not make optimum use of their abilities and educational facilities available in the school. Therefore, there's a great need to develop study habits among the students, raise their achievement motivation, and use the school facilities to the fullest. Proper guidance services can help in this direction. Vocational needs. In our country, natural resources are not being properly utilized because of lack of guidance services. There are the vocational needs for introducing guidance program in the school. Number one, vocationalization of education and guidance. Improvement of vocational efficiency is one of the aims of education. Second, Education Commission has emphasized the need of introduction of crafts in addition to the diversification of the courses at secondary stage, so that a large number of students may take up agriculture, technical, commercial or other practical courses to enable them to go for vocational pursuits. All this calls for proper guidance services in the school. Guidance as an instrument for national development. Guidance by helping, identifying and developing human potential, which is the richest source of the nation, can help to reduce the wastage of educational facilities and abilities, which is so prevalent in our country. There's a need to establish a close link between education and the manpower needs of the country. The sound guidance program can help to achieve this objective in a systematic way. Expanding complexity of the world of work. There has been a tremendous increase in the variety of jobs due to the development of industrialization and mechanization and in every aspect of life. Thus, there's a problem of choice. It is highly important to acquaint the secondary school students with this variety of jobs and with their different requirements. This is possible only through providing organized guidance services in the school system of our country. Need for manpower planning and utilization. For the planned development of a nation like ours, conservation of human resources and manpower planning is very important. A careful balance has to be struck between the manpower needs and the various educational and training programs. To meet the rapidly rising demands of various types of personnel for the various developmental projects, the younger generation of the country will have to be systematically guided into courses of training which will equip them for urgent national needs. Awareness about the different occupations available. A well-organized guidance program is essential for creating occupational awareness among the pupils of the country. The student must be made aware of the various types of jobs available in the employment market so that they may be able to opt those courses during the secondary stage. Therefore, assistance has to be given for making a right choice of the courses at the secondary stage. Changing conditions of industry and labor. Fast changes are taking place today in the conditions of industry and labor. Specialization has become the word of the present age. Moreover, professions have multiplied in numbers. it has become difficult for a common man to make a right choice out of them. Hence, it has become essential to get help of guidance services in the school. Changed economic pattern of the country. Our country is in the era of economic planning. We require scientists, industrialists, software engineers, bankers, etc. to meet the growing demands of the country. The craze for white-collar jobs must come to an end. If proper guidance program is not introduced at the secondary stage in the choice of studies and various vocations, the nation will remain poor and our youth will continue to be frustrated and disgusted. Now, we will be talking about personal needs. Individuals differ in various aspects on account of the three kinds of differences. Different stages of development, differences among persons, and differences in opportunities made available to various persons. It shows that all persons cannot be fit for the same profession. Hence, guidance program is needed in the school system. There are some personal and psychological reasons for the need of guidance, which are as, number one, the basic need of man. Psychologically, no person on this earth is totally independent. The individual needs help of one kind or the other from fellow beings to solve their problems to lead a happy life. Educational and social aspirations. In the present age of competition, the aspiration of the parents are very high. They want their wards to excel in all walks of life. They provide all types of facilities so that the children can be able to get good jobs. To meet the high aspirations of the parents, a well-organized guidance program is needed to make them aware of the potentialities of their children so that they take up right decision at the right time. Developmental needs. The individual passes from different stages of development in the life, such as infancy, childhood, adolescence, and adulthood. One needs different types of helps to adjust with every stage. The adolescent period faces many types of developmental problems. At this stage, the proper guidance is to be provided to the student to make a right choice of his future. Adjustment with the environment. Guidance is needed to help the pupil in making satisfactory psychological adjustment with the environment. Lack of adjustment adversely affects their physical and mental health. Social needs. The points which highlight the social needs of the guidance are complex nature of society. Industrialization is the slogan of the day. Our country is heading towards industrialization, urbanization, and modernization. Changed conditions of living and a highly complex society with its demands have put the individual in constant social and emotional tension. As such, it is highly desirable that school should provide some special services that can look after the emotional and social needs of school-going children. Changed family context. The joint family system is disappearing rapidly and homes are getting disintegrated. The changed family pattern has given rise to the various types of personal problems like loneliness, lack of love and care, etc. The proper guidance program in the school is required to look over these personal issues of the children. Explosion of population and expansion in human resources. Our population has been increasing rapidly. This calls for intensive and extensive guidance in the technique of planning. Right choice of education and occupation. There's a revolution of democratization of political system throughout the world. The education has been made child-centered. The provision of professions and promotions has also been made equal for all human beings. Hence, all people need the help of guidance services for the right choice of education and occupation. Changing concept of education. The concept of education has been changed. The students of today need guidance at every step of education since the education is to be provided according to their interests, aptitudes, and capabilities. Lack of guidance at home. In the past, home was an important agency of education that provided sufficient training in the family occupation and the children adopted the same profession. But now this is not possible due to specialization and different types of occupations available in the job market. There are varieties of jobs and all the people are free to choose the profession they like. Thus, there's a great need of occupational information services to be provided in the school. Dear students, from the above discussion, we can conclude that complex social, economic, and political and educational system has made the guidance and counseling program a necessity. This was all about today's lecture. Hope you have understood and enjoyed. Have a good day. Bye.